G'day guys, welcome back to the channel and another review. Today I will be reviewing Total Jeopardy, which is the 14th episode of the second season of Scooby-Doo and Guess Who. So yeah, let's jump straight into the review. So yeah, like I said, this one was titled Total Jeopardy, which guest starred Alex Trebek. Now, of course, this one is based on the game Jeopardy, which is obviously a real game. Jeopardy, I don't know what you want to pronounce it. It doesn't really matter. Guest starred Alex Trebek, who, of course, hosted the show for a good 40 to 50 almost years, until he unfortunately passed away in 2020, right after this one aired, I believe. So I don't know if it actually did air before he died or after, but thankfully they were able to film this episode before he died, and I guess it's remembered as a bit of a tribute to Alex Trebek, who unfortunately passed away. I do believe he is the only guest star that's passed away. I do believe they're all still alive. He's the only one that I really know of that's actually dead. But it was a interesting episode, that's for sure. I give it a 6 out of 10. The whole Jeopardy thing was interesting. It was something unique, that's for sure. Like, very memorable. Like, no one's going to forget an episode where, you know, the gang had an episode on Jeopardy, which is pretty cool. But it wasn't that good, to be honest. And I guess that's basically, and the main reason why is due to the villain, Max Kilobyte. You're not really a villain, he's just one of the participants in the Jeopardy, along with Shaggy and Velma. He was alright. He didn't really do too much. He wasn't that spooky. I didn't actually really like the design of him. So one of my least favourite guest stars, that's for sure. Sorry, villains in this series. Alex Trebek didn't do a whole lot, but of course you got to have him in, as this episode is Jeopardy, you know. So it was pretty cool. They were pretty much on the Jeopardy set for majority of this episode. They went off it for a good 5 minutes, I believe, for this one. They were just on it for the whole episode, pretty much. Obviously, competing in Jeopardy, you know, they're all they've all come pretty high in terms of rankings, and they're going for the highest ever something and on the show, like highest amount of points on Jeopardy, and would be the Jeopardy champion if you win. Obviously the aim of the game is to try and basically you pick a category for money, and if you get it right, you get that money. And then at the end, of course, is like the I forget what it's called. It's like the big round or the boss round, where basically you can choose to bet all your money onto the question, and if you get it right, I believe you can double it, and if you get it wrong, you lose all your money. It's a very, very confusing and sciencey question. Definitely not my level of understanding, that's for sure. Not yet, that is. It's quite a complex answer. All three of them struggled on that final one, that's for sure. Anyway, basically, Max Kilobyte, he'd been hacked and started, like, going haywire, bashing up the tables and, chasing the gang and Alex Trebek, of course. It was quite weird, to be honest. We've already seen a robot as well in this season, let alone of Scooby-Doo and Guess Who, just a few episodes before, so I thought it was kind of weird how we saw another robot just a few episodes later. And I really did not like this robot. His personality was, you know, made to hate, I guess. He's a character made to hate with that personality of human error is basically the cause of the world's problems. And yeah, he's a bit annoying, that's for sure. He's not that annoying, but he can get a bit annoying. Obviously a bit of a sore loser as well, just wants to win. But that's not really to do with the robot, is it? That's due to the person who was hacking him. Now, besides from Alex Trebek, the other characters we saw was this guy who said he, I guess, owned Max Kilobyte, or at least worked for the company that, you know, sponsors him. And we also got the cameraman of Jeopardy, of course. And I do believe that was it. Not too many characters, that's for sure. Daphne, Fred, and Scooby were a bit of sideshow characters in this one. They weren't, you know, on the screen for as long. But they certainly were, like, you know, still in it. Yeah, they certainly weren't the main points of this episode, which I found interesting. The fact that, you know, those three were just thrown to the side. But anyways, yeah, it's quite an average episode, really. I mean, it's memorable, but it just wasn't executed that well, to be honest. Lots of people I know don't really like this one, but then again, some people do. So, like, it's kind of like either you love it or you hate it. It also depends if you've A, seen Jeopardy, because if you haven't seen it, then you're probably not going to enjoy it. And also, if you like Jeopardy, of course, because if you don't like Jeopardy, you're not going to like this episode, because it's just total Jeopardy, I guess, which is why it's called that. Yeah, I reckon I might change my ranking on this one. Sorry if, you know, it's a bit annoying, I know, but yeah, I will change my ranking on this one to 5.5 out of 10. It's just better to give it a 5.5. It's just not a 6 for me. It was a bit high, I guess. Yeah, it was a pretty average episode. Then we got to the reveal, which was somewhat decent. It turned out to be the cameraman. Now, he hacked Max Kilobyte because he wanted to win at, of course, Jeopardy. He was going to be pretty rich as well if he, you know, won, because it would have shown the world how great Max Kilobyte can be. And if he won, he would have been shipped and sold and put in every home in the world, really. And that would have made him a very, very, very rich man, of course. And of course, he obviously wanted to win Jeopardy, as well. The sly pot, you get a lot of money if you win it. So, you know, it's pretty good to go for that as well. Of course, Velma was pretty smart in this one. Started off pretty well, got a really big bonus head start. So he decided to hack Max Kilobyte and make him go on a rampage, you know, change up his personality a bit. I guess that's, I guess the thing I found a bit weird was when the owner of Max Kilobyte came halfway through the episode to double check why Max Kilobyte was acting weird. He said everything was fine. I think he would have known a little, virus was planted onto his laptop that was hacking Max Kilobyte. So I found that a bit weird. But anyway, because he, of course, was the cameraman of Jeopardy as well, he knew all the answers, so he was super smart. But he still got beaten, though, and somehow Shaggy ended up winning. So I don't know what's happened there. Obviously a bit of a joke, bit of a laugh, but yes, yeah, somehow Shaggy won.
Error my foot. Hacking the system via the IP address. There. And now let's see who's really controlling this Max Kilobyte.
The cameraman!
Who's the cameraman?
I know you hacked into Max and took control of him after planting a chip on the programmer's computer, but I don't know why. Why did you do it?
Money! I invested my entire life savings into Max Kilobyte Robotics, the company that makes these things. They're supposed to be in every home one day. And if Max won Jeopardy, the stocks would have skyrocketed, making me a very, very rich man. But when Velma started winning, I had to do something. I hacked the robot system so I could control him and answer for him. I couldn't let him lose. Years of being a cameraman here on Jeopardy has made me super smart. I knew all the answers. I should have won. And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it weren't for you meddling kids. And famed TV personality and game show host Alex Trebek.
Well, folks, you saw it here first, and hopefully it will be a last.
And fun fact was his only correct answers that he got were food categories, so, yeah, probably why he won there. Lots and lots of food categories were in this Jeopardy episode for some reason. Definitely gave Shaggy the advantage over two very, very, very smart, Jeopardy players. Now, of course, it ended off that episode, which was a memorable one. So, you know, you can't really hate it, can you? But it certainly wasn't too great. 5.5 for me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. And I'll see you guys in the next one.
Giant sandwiches!
Snacks!
Famous mustards!
Pizza toppings!
Eggplants! Guess like I'm really smart about certain things.